cycle. Hi, it is Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa, on a live event, which hopefully, because we did a pre-show, has fabulous sound right from the beginning. Guess what we're doing today? We are painting a leaf with some fall pumpkins. A box frame, hopefully you guys can see that pretty well. Now, of course, you could do this on a small box frame. Hopefully you guys can see that pretty well. Now, of course, you could do this on a small canvas and get a very cute painting too. You could paint it on all kinds of things. You could paint it on a rock. So can you guys see that there really, really well? Your leaf that you're gonna be doing. I have a prepared leaf in Martha Stewart style because I learned from Miss Martha to have one ready to prep and one ready to go. So this is my prepped one. And then I have a begin the lesson leaf. How are you guys doing today? How's everybody doing? We're gonna be doing this with acrylic paint though. I forgot to say that. We've been doing it with acrylic paint. I'm gonna put those colors out.
Oh, you're gonna have so many people out here. We're going, it's exciting.
Is it? Who is here today for the leaf?
So many people out here. We're going, it's exciting.
Is it? Who is here today for the leaf painting? Which I think is going to take about, 30, 40 minutes because we'll be goofing and talking. But it's really actually a pretty fast project.
Yeah. So,
Wow, we got kind of a full house. So you're going to have to give me just a moment here.
Okay, you can have a full house. He's like trying, you know what? It's really interesting. This is one of the hardest challenges of these live events is catching up on the comments, the scrolls, the delays, all of that, plus running the sound, plus running the out broadcast. He's going to be checking to make sure people aren't yelling, oh my goodness, the sync is off, the sound is off. But we did do a pre-show trying to make sure that that wasn't an issue today. We really did. Yep. I'm kind of interested to see who's going to be painting on leaves and who's going to be painting on canvases, because that was the heated debate over on Facebook. Yep. Yes. Because apparently all Florida has no leaves.
Really?
No.
No
leaves. I'm like, you know, eBay, Etsy, lots of places to get leaves, silk leaves. No, they're just a leaf-free zone.
There's no arboretums?
No, apparently not.
Wow.
Apparently not. And it was so sweet is that people in areas that, you know, had leaves would say, hey, I would ship you some leaves if you need some leaves. So I thought that was the sweetest thing.
That's funny.
In the universe. Be like, I'll get you some leaves if you need some leaves. I only have leaves because some of my neighbors painted maples and they just sort of blow up the street. And I was out with the kids trying to come up with an art project. I was like, what do we have a lot of? Oh, it looks like this week we got a lot of leaves.
Wow.
Yeah.
We have so we have a full house of people out there all saying hello. Everyone's so excited about this. It's pretty crazy.
I'm pretty excited to do this. This is my Mr. Miyagi art lesson.
Oh,
we're getting Karate Kid with everybody up here in Heart Party.
Is this like Cat Pressure 101?
This really unlocks it. And look, any of the paintings that I've done, as I'm moving things around, any of the paintings that I've done, you could do in a leaf. Look, there's this one.
That one's nice.
Right? I did a witch sister on a leaf and put it in a shadow box frame. I got that at Hobby Lobby.
Yeah, why don't you try it from the other camera below.
That one. See if this one does it better?
No. I know it's not going to.
No, there's too much reflection there.
What about the palette cam maybe?
No, the palette cam.
Oh, yeah, there
we go. There we go. Palette cam. So you can really see these leaves here, and I'll show them to you again. You know, right now Hobby Lobby in my area was running 50% off frames. You know how they sort of cycle everything 50% off in the store, which makes me wonder what the real price of anything is. But they do that to me every time. I think I am ready to tell people their materials list.
Are you really?
Yes. Theory, I am. In theory, I am.
So over there?
Yes,
okay,
right here.
Right there.
So we do have one weird paint color that you can optionally have today.
What's that?
I'm trying to hold it here. It is nickel azo gold.
Ooh.
And it has a quinacridone name also, which I never like to say. So I just go nickel azo. I like it. It is a very translucent, bright kind of color. you know, you've got to kind of have a chemistry degree. Like, it'll tell you in the back transparency. It says opaque, but actually, I find it's not. It's, oh no, it does say transparent, and then it's a high gloss and medium thinness and low tint. So it just, wow, it just gives you some great effects. You don't have to have it for this event. I also have here some gesso. Clear gesso. I'm going to hold it up to this camera. Clear gesso. Yeah.
I thought someone was saying that they didn't have clear gesso.
You know, you wouldn't
go back up there.
You wouldn't have to have clear gesso, but really Michaels and Hobby Lobby and all of that carry clear gesso. And you can get it online, and you wouldn't need it for canvas if you're doing it on canvas. So here's the deal on the leaves. You could go out and get a green leaf and press it in a book and get a nice flat surface, which would be a beautiful effect and a beautiful project. You can go on YouTube and look up how to glycerin preserve a leaf, which we definitely did want to do because that would actually, it makes the leaf very flexible and forever. Or you can just go out into your yard and you get a leaf and you can hit it with a little clear gesso to stabilize it, and then, and it stabilizes it only mildly.
It was Kim who was asking, could you use matte medium instead?
Yeah, if it's clear, yeah.
Clear matte medium?
Maybe. Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just, what I wanted was, I wanted to surface prep the leaf a little bit.
Yeah.
Just because I thought I'd be doing this with the kids. I'm going to show you how I did that. I'm going to take a practice leaf right here. And can we see the practice leaf on the, because we have a new cam, yeah. Right?
Well, no, yeah, it's the same camera, just in a different place.
It's tripping me out, though. It's a different place.
It's the craft camera.
I'm using, I'll show them to you. I'm using smaller brushes today. Today is the day to get out your teeny tiny brushes. So this is my assorted set of brushes, and I'm going to, this is my biggest brush today, which is like a half inch is my biggest. It's a number 12 Ebony Splendor by Creative Mark. I'm going to dampen my brush just a little bit, but mostly that's to get the sizing out of it, and then I'm going to wipe it off on a towel and just get a little of this clear gesso, and you're just going to do a thin coat on your leaf. If you guys are painting in journals or doing lots of multi-layered projects, clear gesso is really fantastic. Clear gesso is what they put on the back of burlap, interestingly enough. I don't really know how it's useful on the back. But this is all you're doing, and you just brush this on. See, it just goes on really easily. And where you see it thick, I made a little mistake. Like, I put it on a little too thick when I first prepped the leaves.
Mm-hmm.
But again, I was painting with the kids. So I thought that there would, I was pretty sure there was going to be. Here's a spider leaf.
Oh, yeah.
This is a spider original work of art that he did, and this was really good for him. He has some, I don't know, he's got some hand coordination pressure kind of working that out issues, and we've been painting on feathers and leaves. This is really great if you're working on sensory integration. We've been painting on leaves and feathers to help him learn to regulate how hard he's pressing down.
Yeah.
Been really effective in that, and fantastic. It's good for you as artists. Oh, I'm loving my sippy sippy today. Things you can paint on, and we will be painting on in future.
Ooh,
feathers. Yeah, because there's nothing as awesome as, say, like a trout coming up on a feather, an eagle. It's just really cool. And you can see with the shadow box that, you know, so we can even see this right here, look.
Ooh.
You can see the painting. It doesn't, it only, you can really only see the color in the good cam.
Yeah, just, you know. Bigger iris.
Bigger iris, brighter color. But see, little canvas would work, guys. This one is already dry. So, I hope we have some leaves. Do we have any leavers with us today?
I think that I will. We'll take a poll. We'll see who's painting leaves with us and who's painting along.
I like that poll. Yeah. It's a very good poll. So here's the deal, guys. Biggest issue in your art practice is pressure.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That's one of the first big things, more than rendering skills, more than drawing skills, is a series of techniques, and one of the key ones is pressure. Is how hard you press on something, if you can do dry brushing, if you can do light technique, it really helps you bring those painting practices home and makes it more enjoyable with your skills. Grandma Moses did not do highly rendered, beautiful figure drawing, but she did have her art techniques down, And here she was, one of our most important artists in the country. So all I'm saying is this is a really fun way to impress your friends and family, to impress yourself, and to work on a skill that can be kind of challenging to initially learn. And you have a fun project. But I'm just helping you out. Like, imagine this for the holidays. You paint up a bunch of little leaves with different heart party paintings. You put them in shadow boxes. You ship them out. People are like, oh, what? You should quit your job and just be an artist. That's what they would totally say to you. So that's your thing. Paint on a bunch of leaves and send them out as Christmas gifts. I'm taking the little dogs. And I forgot to tell people the colors.
Oh, wait.
Did I?
No.
Did I already tell them the colors?
No, you started to. And then
I got distracted. Let's do the colors.
You got distracted. You were talking about the one fancy optional color, and then you forgot to talk about the regular ones.
Yep, I did. Dogs in purple. Burnt sienna, cad red medium. You can get hue to save some money. Cad yellow medium also comes in hue to save some money. We nickel azole gold if you choose. Phthalo blue, titanium white, and of course our clear gesso. Oh, and spray varnish. Some kind of spray varnish for when you're done. We have a...
And you put all that in the description?
Yeah. Or if I haven't yet, I will as soon as we're offline.
And what brush are you using there?
I am using that same half-inch Filbert Ebony Splendor number 12. And I've taken a little burnt sienna and a little dog's in purple. And I'm going to come here. And I'm going to just very lightly brush this on to the canvas. Now, I might come over here. I really like the purple and the nickel azole as well. It's a subtle difference, guys, but it's a fabulous color. If you get it, you can do burnt sienna and dog's in purple the whole way through. I'm adding a little white, letting the white pick up a little bit of these colors. Okay, just adding a little white, pick up some of these colors. Come over here and get some nickel azo. But again, you could do this burnt sienna all the way through, not rinsing off my brush. We've kind of done a version, I'm gonna come back over my burnt sienna. We've kind of done a version of this background on a lot of our paintings. So imagine if you successfully have done the fox, imagine the fox on a leaf in a shadow box as a gift. How much would that just blow somebody you love's mind this holiday season? Or your own. Just put them all over your house. Trip people out.
That would.
It really does. People are always like, when you paint on something non-traditional, they just freak out. They're like, you can do that?
Well, you know who was just shocked to see something in the background? It was Mona. She had saw her little owl there in the background.
Well, yeah.
She was like,
yeah, and with Leola's spoon necklace.
Yeah.
Which I could have, you know what? I was looking for that today. I was like, I need to wear it. And then.
It is right there.
Because nothing messes me up more than putting things away.
When I clean the studio.
Oh. You call it cleaning. I call it moving everything where I knew where it was. Where did it go? So I'm just trying to break up, if you'll notice this, I'm picking up these different colors, and I'm just trying to create this very, oh, there's Luna. She's our loudest child, which if you've been with us a while, you know that. If this is the first time you've been here and you're still here, hi, we do painting process videos all the time, and we just go through step by step, but normally we do paint on canvas. Normally it's canvas, and normally it's just the set of colors without the nickel azole, but we've been talking about putting in some more colors just on occasion. But again, I thought this was a safe one to introduce because it's not necessary. All right, see how that is right there? Nice little, can you see that? I'm gonna hold it up to this camera so we can really kind of
see all the painterly nature of it.
The painterliness.
You know, one could confuse that with a leftover palette.
Yeah, one could. One could also remember who prepares one's food. Actually, a lot of times that's John, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's become the egg master in our house, just on a Sunday brunch kind of theme. Used to be me, And John made this, like, the worst eggs ever. I would, like, hear about it from the kids nonstop. And he took some sort of personal challenge on about that. And now I don't even want to go out and eat eggs. So I'm not sure that that was good planning on your part, sweetie.
That's right.
Were you thinking? So I might need to, but I don't see it.
Before you jump on, what are you sippy-sippying on there?
I'm doing a Moscato and orange juice, so it's not quite a no-mosa.
It's a mimosa.
A mimosa. So there's not a champagne shortage in Texas or something. There's just always a series of events, which means that by the time I get to a show, I don't have champagne. Just
wrong bottle open.
Wrong bottle open for nighttime relaxing. I'm like, well, I guess we're celebrating now. So how are you guys liking this project?
Well, yeah, I think that at least a couple people are painting along with us. I know Mark. I think Mark is. I think Kim is. I have to go back and see.
That's awesome.
Yeah, there were several people. And we've had some very nice compliments that our sound is working reasonably well today.
Our sound is working. So, telling you what, man.
So this is what we're painting?
This is what we're painting. This is how it's going to look on a canvas if you do it on a little canvas. This is, I think, you know what, it's a 3x5 or 4x, it's a small canvas.
It's a small canvas.
I have some measurements in the description. I think I put this stuff in the description.
So, but we're.
And if I didn't, I will right away. Yes. And we're going to be doing some more pumpkin stuff. And hey, look, if you guys want to do this with the kids, this is how that looks.
Yeah. Turns out nice.
Turns out super nice. Anything in the comments?
Oh my gosh, everyone's in the comments. They're loving everything. Well, they think that the Sippy Sippy is great.
Thank you.
They love your hat, by the way.
I am so digging my hat. Let me give you the full 360 without
the
getting
hat
killed.
Around.
Well, no, it's the cable. It's the leash. It's the sound leash, which I'm not as good at managing as I... This is a really different view of my studio, isn't it?
Not really. It's just a little different.
So.
But you like your camera. So are you sticking with the filbert there for this?
Well, you know what? Today actually is either detailed rounds or filberts because I forgot to open the package of brights.
Oh.
So, but that's okay because that's what I painted the test one in. And, you know, you just work it out. I'm always working on them. I'll do them on Periscope. Oh, listen, can you guys do me a favor? I forgot to announce, like, I don't think on social media, like, right before I was going on. So you guys can share it and let people know it's on. I totally...
Please,
you don't have to, just if you can, because I completely... We get so flustered.
Yes.
Before a live event.
Sound checks, light checks, turning on and on.
I was so flustered before being on Ask a Crafter with Lindsay and Frugal Crafter. So flustered.
Oh. That was pretty...
So but much, and now it wasn't even my broadcast, and I was like, so much stuff, okay, is everything okay? I had, like, books, y'all didn't know this, but off camera, I had all of my art reference materials, because I figured people were going to throw some crazy questions at me that I was going to have no idea, and then the one question I didn't know was for a patina crafting medium that you would normally use in faux finishing or woodworking, which I wouldn't know.
No way.
And then I looked up, and it's really cool, and now I'm going to do a bunch of stuff with it, so there you go. All right, I think that this is dry. I would normally just do a hair dryer, but I guess I could go like this.
No, we get to chat.
We get to chat. So I'm going to get a smaller brush. This is, I don't know. I think this is like a, we don't have our ruler, but it's like a quarter inch.
Yeah, it looks nice.
And I'm going to start laying in my pumpkin. So how I'm going to do this is I'm going to take my phthalo over to my cad red. And I'm going to mix it, and I'm going to get a deep brick color. It's a cousin of this burnt sienna here. And if I had to, like, fake burnt sienna, that's how I would fake it. Like, if you run out of burnt sienna, a little phthalo and cad red will get you darn close. Really close. And you're like, you can just paint that in. It's a little redder. It's a little hotter.
Everyone thinks you were awesome on Ask a Crafter.
Really? Oh, so fun to be on there. I was just really excited.
Yeah.
really excited.
It was fun. You were all nervous.
Yeah, she's so nice. But yeah, I was completely nervous. Yeah. So I'm just doing a little sort of squished round shape here. And I'm just paint that in. It's really that simple. This is a very simple painting. You know, if you can handle circles and little painterly brush strokes, you can get this set of pumpkins in. And we've got more, I don't know why I'm going over the nickel. We've got some more pumpkin-y stuff coming up, I think, this week, if you're not on the road.
Yeah, we'll probably, you know, we'll have some stuff. Even if I am on the road, we may have some stuff ready.
Okay. So that should be kind of fun. We're going to pumpkin it up a little bit.
Try to have some more stuff in.
Yeah. I'm really loving how the Think Pink Art event is going for the Creative Arts Collaboration. Some of the videos that were created by the artists were incredible. So now I'm going to come over and I'm going to do the opposite. I'm going to take the cat over to the phthalo blue. And you could also do the burnt sienna over the phthalo blue. What I'm trying to do is I'm getting a gray. Makes an interesting blue-gray. Just find your color. And I'm going to make a smaller little circle here that's going to overlay a little bit. Overlay a little bit. The first red pumpkin. You know, and again, you don't have to be as careful as I'm being here. It's just a pretty relaxed thing. Listen, this is really going to show you how to lighten up your hand.
How to have that.
Because you're going to be thinking about it in a different way. This is just a way that I know tricks the brain into considering what's going on in your brush pressure. Right?
Yep.
And that's sometimes what it is. Like, you'll try to trick your brain one way. I don't know why. It's like, I'm not adversarial with my brain, but sometimes you're just trying to get your brain to think about it a different way. As you know, when we're young, sometimes it's really easy to take on some of these new things, but as we get older, it can be hard to just embrace a lot of new skills. Our brain sometimes needs a couple little tricks.
Yep.
And you should always be like up for it, like embracing. I think I'm making this one kind of more oblongy. Taking it over here. We're gonna have leaves and things down at the bottom. So this is not how you would paint this project with a watercolor. So and turn your leaf. Like if you're having a bad angle, turn your leaf. That's the other thing. This is going to really help you think about how you approach angles and things on a painting. All right, got that there. Rinse that out. And then I'm going to add just a little shadow under everything. So I'm going to get a little burnt over to the blue and a little purple. Want something dark. Something dark. Now you can make these jack-o'-lanterns if you wanted to. Need more purple even. You make these like jack-o'-lanterns. We're going to be coming back with lots of little leaves and things.
So Mark was saying he had a blast with the last CAC event.
Did he? He did a great job.
Yeah.
Mark did some really good stuff for this. And if you haven't seen Mark's tutus, you haven't lived. Mark in a tutu. Mark in a tutu. You haven't lived until you've seen it. I really feel like I'm now complete.
Yeah.
it's really awesome.
So, yeah, that, and they were, let's see here. Oh, there was just lots of comments going on. I have not been keeping up. Oh,
grab a comment.
They were asking about travel, where I'm going and what the travel plans are, why I'm going on. So, I'm starting up a small company. So I travel out of town a lot, working on different sales opportunities, working with different development partners and stuff like that. And hopefully that'll slow down here in the beginning of the year. But you know, it takes me out and about. So we try to get some videos done ahead of time and keep those ready for you guys.
But that's pretty much why we don't have like a Wednesday, Friday schedule yet. But as soon as we can, we're going to. Or maybe it's Tuesday, Thursdays. I don't know. Yeah, my mom's on Tuesdays, so I'm kind of inclined to be like Wednesday, Friday. Like have mom solidarity, right? She's so cute. She's like, but Tuesday is my day. I'm like, okay, mom. That's all good. YouTube is big, but that's fine. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I've made a very dark color. And I'm going to come down from the top. Let me see if I can zoom in on this even. Ooh, it's the wrong direction. How's that?
Ooh.
Right there. Is it focused on it? And I'm going to make a little dark area. Kind of coming around. This is where the stem is going to be. It also tells me the tilt of my pumpkin. I'm going to come over here, making that a little dark area. It tells me the tilt of my pumpkin.
See, this is where I think that we need to have that the other palette actually on the palette cam. Because see here, when you're zoomed in nice like this, we can't see what you're doing with the palette.
Well, I could...
If you set your palette over there. Over there.
I could try. It's really cross angle for me.
Oh. Remember because you're right-handed.
Yeah.
So we're going to have to swap the palette from here to here.
We'll try.
And back. And then
I'm going to try. I'm going to try it. Because I would rather that I be just a little bit off my game than honestly that they have a hard time with everything. Really, truly mean that too. I'd rather that I'm just a little bit like, what is going on? Now I'm going to come under here and my leaf has a center line and I found that this is really actually quite helpful. Because I initially put my pumpkin, and it was something I didn't realize until I painted several leaves, and I was like, you know, I'm using that center vein to ground my objects. So sometimes nature can help you. And I'm going to create a little round U shape. And I'm going to just make, coming up a little bit, some ribbles. Technical term here, guys. Ribbles. Come around here.
I have to get used to where the cameras are as well, because they're...
It's a whole thing. Here we go. We're trying to do this. Normally, traditionally, on YouTube, what you would get is a sort of video recorded step-by-step of a project like this. You know, but I want you guys to really be able to do it, so we're doing the full... We resisted the step-by-step where it goes, get a leaf, coat a leaf. Brush your leaf. You know.
Because then you miss out on all the fun talking that goes in between it.
You miss out on all the fun talking. And when you guys have done this a few times, you'll be ready for those.
Yeah.
I want you guys to be ready for those and go take full advantage of what's going on out there.
And then when you miss us, you can come back.
Well, I don't think. I think they will always come back. I think our community is the best community on YouTube.
So the only problem with the cameras being swapped now is it's not intuitive for my fingers, so I can't.
I could call it out. You'd be palette. We could be like chefs. Leaf.
No, I'm pretty good. It's just, you know, you get to a place where switching can be second nature, you know.
Yeah.
And then.
You said I didn't have to call.
Oh no, you're okay. I'm just. It's. Every time I lean back on where I believe it should be. Instead,
I'm going to go to the palette now. And I'm back. There's a really evil part of me that wants to mess with him when we're doing this. And I'm just resisting that because it just messes with you guys too. Take that. So you have this sort of very dark. And I'm going to hold this up to the camera that really picks up the colors. That's going to be one of our things that we invest in next is a camera like this for the other two cameras.
Yeah, we need more.
We need more of these. Clearly, for what we do, is not our. What's going on?
Zoomed it. It's gonna fix itself in a minute.
It had a little trouble with the palette. It was having a whole moment there, wasn't it?
It was trying to focus on the reflective light.
We're not winning any videography awards. They have those streamies.
Yeah, that's
the streamies.
We don't.
I don't know, there's a viewer's choice. Go vote for me. That would be so funny.
I don't know what.
Can you imagine them going, wait, what?
We would qualify for the special streamies.
Yeah. So we've got our leaf here, and I've got to let her dry, or John's got to get me a hair dryer.
There's one on the floor.
Where did it go? I don't see it anywhere on the floor, my darling. Oh. It's not under my mat. I see the plug for it.
Wow. Well, you know what?
It's right. It's on my easel. I'm not gone. Don't report me. I'm right here. Don't report me. Shoot, I don't know, the YouTube police. I know. When you move my easel, I don't know where my ruler is. Oh, and the reason we're not doing wishes, you're going to have to do your wishes today in your heart. Because you really can't write on the leaves.
What, could we do it on the back of the leaf?
No, I really looked at that. So I want you to whisper your wish to your leaf, and then you're going to put it in the frame. Oh. I mean, the wishes are really intentions, aren't they?
Yeah.
So we're going to do, if you have a canvas, absolutely write your wishes in. But that's the only reason why we don't have wishes. So just whisper wish to your leaf.
Okay. All right. I'll turn down your volume now, and you can do your.
Okay.
Or
not.
Or not.
Am I not plugged in? Yep. Keep a good grip on the leaf. This is really tripping me out.
All right. All right.
Okay. Now I'm going to start laying in a little of the green. The bottom's going to get some phthalo and some cad yellow.
I'm always nervous touching the sound.
Are you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's
so hard. All right. So we're definitely having to go across here. Now I'm going to add a little of the burnt. Just to darken this. And I want you just to...
Can you pull your camera back just a touch?
Here we go. How about that?
There you go. Perfect.
Is that good? Hopefully you guys can see. We're just going to make little dashes.
Yeah.
With these. Don't... A lot of people tell you that because you're doing this on a leaf that this is a craft. And they'll say it in kind of a way. But first of all, craft is art. I don't really know why we break up the categories as much as we do. I mean, I do, but I don't necessarily personally, emotionally agree with it. I'm going to bring a leaf up into my pumpkin here. And then I'm also going to place one right here. Right here. 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 Okay, so that's just sort of marking. Hold this up for you guys to see. The location of your leaves. You know, you're doing all the same stuff you'd have to do if you painted this on a canvas. It's like really the same stuff. Take a little of this green. And also on this, seeing it, we're going to add a little bit of green down here to the segments. Just want a little bit of it. Even though we come back with the white, there was a green undertone. There's these weird spotty pumpkins that I'm sure some people know the name of, that I don't know the name of. Now I'm going to make a little green and get a little brown in it. A little more brown in it. Pretty dark forest green. I've got this small brush here. I don't know what I'm showing it to. And I'm going to come in the center of my dark spot and make a little curve line out. And that's my stem. I'm going to come and curve line out. So the line is kind of like this here.
That's a little off. It's a little off.
There okay, I'll try here. Can I? Or is it? There we go.
You can kind of see it there.
There you go. So this is definitely an interesting project to do a full tutorial on. I might zoom out just. Whoa, wait, that's nice actually. So you guys can really see that. Ooh, but I'm so lost.
Nausea cam times 10.
Nausea cam times 10. All right. So I'm going to zoom out. That is not out.
I'm just going to leave it there to torture everyone.
Stop. Be good. All right. So that's... How's it working out for you all? You know, you have an idea in the privacy of your home with your kids going, oh, I could just show everyone to paint leaves. Feathers, it'll be great. Be so fall. I'll make a hat.
Yeah, so you do make your hat, huh?
I do. These hats, when they're this craziness, that's definitely... John's been married to me for a while. He'll tell you that's an all cinnamon kind of... When it's got a big frog...
That's definitely a
But the knit ones, I'm not a good hooker.
No,
you don't. I have no hooking skills at all. No. I just love to say that. I got no hooking skills. I'm not a good hooker. Is that what crocheters who are good call themselves? I really hope that's true and somebody wasn't messing with me. That would be so crazy awful, wouldn't it?
Well, for you it would be. I think that frog might jump right off your head and attack you.
That would be awesome. All right, we're going to work on mixing some orange here. What makes orange? Yellow and red make orange. And it doesn't take very much red to come in and make an orange. I'm going to need a little water. Oh, wait, I think I have water over here. I don't have to go across anymore. I see it.
Stop psyching me out.
I'm just trying to find a mid-range orange. And I'm going to come. And I'm going to, from the dark spot, I'm just going to make a little soft, painterly little stroke down that follows my plan and my ribs. And see, your leaves, if you don't press them, your leaves may have some crazy shapes going on that you have to work around. And that's actually really good for you as an artist. You may not at this moment be feeling like it's a really good thing for you as an artist. And you may have some choice words for me. But it actually really is good for you to learn how to deal with these compound curves on this leaf and still get your painting across. So, you know, like I said, we are fun art, not fine art, but I am teaching you how to paint. We're just doing it in a way that, you know, every once in a while, I don't know, like camp, like, you know, I wish artist retreats were often like, I wish it was leaf painting. Let's all paint a leaf now to work on our technique of pressure. It'd be great. I would show up for that. It's coming down here. And then, of course, you got to show that, you know, that there's these ribs going out. So... those out there. Now I like a little, I actually want some lighter green down there. I'm going to rinse out my brush a little bit. And I want you to take a little of your purple, right? Just a scotch of yellow. It's going to gray out your purple quite a lot. And you're going to get it into the white. It shouldn't be clearly purple. It should be like a putty color.
Ooh.
And I'm going to come over here and I'm going to do the same thing. Light brush strokes down showing the ribs of my pumpkin. And I'm like dealing with my... See, I've got this little leafy thing here. I'm dealing with it. It's happening to me right now.
Cut me reading comments.
You got comment reading?
I was reading comments. I didn't see you move your hands.
That's okay. I was just getting more of that same color. So see, I'm just pulling this down. It's just a painterly little pumpkin. You can come back and define the ribs again if you need to. Right? You can adjust. You can work it out. Right? Now, get a little of your yellow. I'm going to get nickel azo here. And a little white. And I'm going to come up. Nah, not really. A little more burnt sienna, I think. Come up on my stem. Make a little highlight there. Come up on my stem. A little highlight. You know, if you need to get to a smaller brush, get a smaller brush. I need to put my dark back in because I got a little cray cray with it. And that's what it is on these small pieces, is you may be putting shadows back in. You may be putting like your ribs back in. You know, and don't be afraid if that's something that you've got to do. With your pumpkin. Just a happy little painting. Just a happy little painting. Let's get a bright green going. Let's get a little phthalo and blue and add a little white to it. A little more yellow. And let's add some bright green to this ground. Maybe some grass-like little shape there. Little dabs. I'm gonna come up my leaf here. Define my leaf. Add a little of my stem. Come up my leaf. It can be a little challenging. Don't be stressed if it is. It's okay for it to be challenging. Absolutely okay for it to be a real challenge. Come get a little more of your cad red. Add just a scotch of yellow to it. It'd be kind of bright. Let's add some of that. Isn't that nice, John?
Oh yeah, it looks really nice.
Thank you.
I have to really pay attention here because I can't read the comments and rely on my brain to automatically switch to the right camera.
So well, after this orange, we'll take a comment break.
Yeah.
We'll take a comment break and kind of catch up.
I really like how the layers of paint are coming on there, though.
It really is. You're kind of catching this little story in all of our paintings, isn't it? That yeah. It's just layers of paint. This is just about layers of paint. Any of the paintings we've done on Heart Party, Starry Night looks really good on a leaf.
Actually, flip the leaf around. Just turn it around. Looks okay. Really nice.
It's coming in.
Yeah.
We're working it out. So let's do some comments.
Oh, yeah. That's
I'm going to refresh.
So someone was asking, would it was Mona. Mona was saying, would Australian sienna work?
Love it. Love it.
Yeah.
In this painting. It gets you the brightest, craziest greens. It gets you the brightest, craziest oranges. I love it.
And it appears Kim Sim is coming to Texas next week.
She's been saying that. Where is Kim heading, though? I don't think she's in Houston.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm trying to scroll through. There's lots of comments up there. I don't think she says specifically. You know what we should do is have her post up where her hotel is so all of our crazy stalker people could just show up.
Which we have none of.
Yeah, no, we don't. Don't do that.
We have none of them, and it's okay, Kim. None of them. We're not that kind of YouTube show. You know. But then I'm not going to drive a leopard car around and wear a silly face mask. So that's probably good for all of us. I might drive a Heart Party like motorhome around. Can you imagine if I got a big giant motorhome and I skinned the whole thing like with Heart Party art? It was like Heart Party art Sherpa. Would that just be like bananas?
Well, we're working on
I would totally do that. So I guess I have a little bit in common with Justin Bieber.
Well, we're totally.
But not being able to sing. We do not have that in common.
Nice.
What else is going on?
Oh gosh. Let's see, there's lots of joking going on. Lots Good. Of sippy sippy comments going on.
Sippy sippy. Sippy sippy on a Sunday.
And everyone seems to really like the pumpkins.
Everybody, you know what? Pumpkins are a very happy squash. They are the happiest of the squashes.
Are they? Would you take a poll?
No.
I guess they're the least squashed.
I actually did just say that to say it, like right now, just to say it. I was just like, just talking.
You think? Well, we should paint them then.
I'm going to go back to painting them.
We should paint them.
So I'm going to go back and I'm going to get some white paint. I'm going to get some white paint, some straight white. And I'm going to come and I'm going to work this little pumpkin a little bit. I'm coming on my edge, being careful with how I'm painting it. Trying to define. See, then that leaf bump, it got me. And that's a thing. And you know what, guys? If it's frustrating to paint a leaf, Breathe. Here's why. If you're in a car accident or anything happens to you medically, what's the first thing, John, that they give you at the hospital? What's the first thing that they do?
I have no idea what they do.
I don't actually know, because I'm not a nurse, but I believe it's put oxygen on your face. I mean, it just seems like every time I'm anywhere and I'm having any kind of moment, they stick some oxygen on my face. If my plane is crashing, what do they give me? They give me a little cup of oxygen so I don't feel so bad. You know what I mean? It's just, well, that's how I feel about it, but I don't fly well. John almost took film of me on my last flight because it's so funny to share with you guys. I don't fly well, so I may not... I'm probably not going to be picked up as a spokesman for the airlines anytime soon. So I'm just adding this little highlight here of this white for this white pumpkin. Doesn't it look nice?
It does.
Oh, it's just lovely. Just lovely. Now, another thing you can do, if you have the nickel azole gold and you add a little white to it, you can get this incredible color right here, which is one of my fave colors. And you can come and put this, you can also just do this with orange, by the way, so any of your oranges will do this as well. And you can add some of this to your pumpkins, defining those little ribs just a little bit.
Yeah,
it's fun to do, it's enjoyable. I'm gonna get some just cad red. I'm gonna go bananas here, John. I'm gonna go crazy.
Oh no.
And I'm gonna add some cad. Little dabs of it. Not everywhere. A little dab here, and I come along this edge here. I hear you typing. Is everything okay?
Oh yeah.
Put a little cad down in my little leaf bed. A little cad down there with the leaves. That's sort of fun, right?
I'm just, you know, interacting with our community chat.
As you should. I'm going to get some burnt sienna and maybe some of our cad yellow. And I'm going to make almost a yellow ochre, but I didn't feel like putting out yellow ochre. But sometimes it's good to know, hey, I could make burnt sienna with cad red and phthalo blue, or almost yellow ochre with cad yellow and burnt sienna. Little facts you didn't know you needed to know. I'm going to just, with this detail brush, kind of define my stem a little bit. Maybe add a little grass, like right here. With this gold. What if we did that?
Have to excuse me. There's always someone who asks about the rain lamp in the background, which I think is funny.
Because it's awesome. Got two of them. Yep. And some macrame hanging tables. Because we're funkily. If you go to my Pinterest page, you're going to notice that I have some mid-century modern pins. And I might be fond of some mid-century owls and mushrooms. And that was before the trend was even on.
Yeah, that's true. We were all.
I just happened to call it and had an owl do pretty well.
Yeah.
But that was happening whether everybody agreed with me or not. I was getting into my owls for sure. I really love that. And you know, we're on Instagram. You can share your artwork on Instagram. You can share your artwork on Facebook with me. You can tweet with me. I do Periscope. Periscope, I do a lot of like really different stuff. I might do like, I've got some dark, the dark purple and brown here. Basically, I grab some burnt sienna and some dark purple. And I'm just making sure that I've got nice shadows happening around my pumpkin. So that it feels very pumpkin-y. See how I'm working these little darknesses too?
You do.
Define this space. I'm going to come here around my stem. Down. So I'm here. I am having a little trouble necessarily answering every single comment these days, but I am reading them still. John can verify that I get on there and make a point of reading what people have to say.
Yep, I keep pushing the wrong button.
So I'm just darkening those.
You know, it does look like Kim is coming to Houston. I think.
Really?
Yeah, I think Mona said she may be coming to Houston too.
That would be, oh my goodness. Then it's totally on. We're doing something.
We'd have to like.
We're gonna have to have we're gonna have to have Kim and Mona maybe in the studio to paint.
Stop by.
You don't have to. Not like calling you out in public or nothing. I'm just saying you can come by like Todd and Ian did.
Yeah. Todd and Ian, the frugal crafter. The kilted crafter.
Off-kilter crafter. There we go. See, now you've done it.
Do we have so many different variations on crafters and and so many similar names.
Let's see, it's a whole thing. So I've sort of redefined that there. I'm going to come back and get a little of my white paint. Maybe I'll add a little blue to it. So it has a slight blue cast.
But I think they're up for joining us.
That's awesome. Yeah, I missed Sky when she came to town. I was really bummed about that. But she was able to meet my mom, and that was nice.
Oh, yeah.
I think we had sick kids was what it was.
Lots of people are really enjoying the leaf today.
Woo! Because it's fun, guys. It's so fun to do you a little leaf. See, we've got that there. Now I'm going to come get... There's teeny tiny, Phil, but it's a teeny tiny. It's a little package of these. This is what they call number 4, which is a completely different size on anyone else's brush. I'm going to come get quite a bright yellow-orange. I might even add a little white to this, guys. I'm going to come here. Just brush lightly down with this. That isn't that fun?
Looking really nice.
I'm liking it. And then I really want to get some sherbet in there, so I'm going to get in my mid-orange. Sherbet. I'm going to go get some sherbet. Add a little white to it. And I get almost a sherbet color. I can add that in there. I'm just layering the colors. And if you feel like you've lost too much of your, you know, bright, you can get right back into your CAD. Right back into your CAD. Just layer. You can't really overlayer this. Add some more of these little leaves down here. And we're nearly done, guys. I want some blue with a little of the burnt sienna that's grayed out, not so vibrant, and then the white. It's just a little of that tone. This one just needs it. There we go. And I'll add just touches of that color at the bottom. Sometimes a painting is about having touches and touches and touches of color. Get your detail round out. Your teeny tiny detail round. And you're going to get your yellow and your phthalo, and you're going to make a green. You're going to add a lot of white to that green. You want this to be more yellow than blue on that green. So it might take a couple seconds to get it because you want it to sort of pop. And I'm going to wind very carefully some stems. Some vines. Doesn't take a lot, just a little bit. All right. Look at you. I'll hold it up to the camera.
That's looking pretty good.
Pumpkins on a leaf.
Pumpkins on a leaf.
Frame that sucker up. Do it on, I mean, it's not that different. Hey. Yeah.
It's looking pretty good.
Pretty awesome, right?
Yeah.
Put it in. I guess we'll show it here because that was a good one. A shadow box.
Oh, there we go. There you go. Shadow box.
Put it in a shadow box. Right. Seal them with a little varnish. I've been getting this question, how long is it going to last? I don't know. Longer than you?
If you take care of it.
If you take care of it, I don't know. It depends on how well you're taking care of yourself. Taking care of the leaf. I don't really know. There's a lot of factors.
A while. Don't put it in the sunlight.
Once it's in the shadow box, once you've sprayed it with varnish and put it in the shadow box, about the time you're sick of looking at it, maybe. Sometimes art is about being not permanent. If it has to be really permanent, if you want somebody digging your leaf up in a few hundred years, glycerin the sucker. But if it's just good enough to have something beautiful on your wall for the period of time that you would enjoy it, or when you give it to a friend, to have that fill their life with joy for the period, you know. My mom and I are terrible. We never think of art as permanent fixtures. We're like, change it out seasonally and stuff. But it will. It will go a long time. Once you put the varnish on it, and I got a UV Krylon varnish at Hobby Lobby and sprayed and I looked at it. I mean, you've UV'd it, you've sealed it, you put it in a box. You've slowed down. I'm not saying it's like going to stay like the Egyptians, but for the purposes of your uses, long time. So hopefully this, I don't know. Did anyone have fun doing art brunch? I kind of like this art brunch thing. I think we should do feathers next.
Oh gosh, feathers would be great. I think everybody out here has said so much how they've enjoyed the leaves, they've enjoyed the pumpkins, and enjoyed being out here today with us. And thank everyone for joining us. We really appreciate it. You know, please take comment, you know, like, comment, subscribe.
Yeah, like, you were very quiet on the like, comment, subscribe. Usually John's like every 5 minutes, like, comment, subscribe.
Well, I don't want to hound people. I don't want to be pestery. But, you know, it does let YouTube know that we're out here and you guys like what we're doing. So we do appreciate it.
We do. We appreciate it a lot. And I want you guys to be good to yourselves. Whisper your wishes to your leaves. Show me pictures of what you did. And every once in a while, we'll get off the canvas and we'll paint something in an unexpected way. But remember, if for some reason you don't have a rock or a feather or a leaf where you live, you're just I feel like now I kind of like want to paint a palm frond. So like everybody in Florida is like, oh, okay, yeah, I can totally paint like some big banana leaf. It's like a big installation. But you know, canvases will also work on all these projects. So I'm going to see you at the easel or the table or the feather or the rock or something really soon. Bye-bye.